'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the streets the vendors were selling their presents and sweets. The stockings were hung on the chimney by Garrett, in hopes that St. Nicholas would bring him a carrot. The figures had gathered together as one, at Two Pines Inn Lodge, to have lots of fun. With no cares in the world, they laughed with glee, and danced around the big Christmas tree. My family actually helped build the set. It was a great time I won't soon forget. My mom, cousin, aunts, and grandma pitched in. They loved this here outhouse, it gave them a grin. It has even got toilet paper inside, and the snowmobile for figures to ride. My favorite part, please subscribe to my channels, is this skating rink's cool shimmery panels. Then if you push this button on top, the light inside glows. We've got wood to chop. All these sloped roofs just covered in snow, and with all that said, let's get back to the show. As they enjoyed their holiday mirth, a devious plot was about to unearth. Out of the shadows arose he who brings fear that would soon ruin all their Christmas cheer. The elf on the shelf, it was he who had come, a nightmare incarnate, the lowest of scum. Like a thief in the night, he hurried around. He had some big plans for mischief in town. Things back in the cabin were bright as can be, a mood of contentment and an air of carefree. The presents were opened, the fire was glowing, the party inside showed no signs of slowing. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, Grog ran out the door to see what was the matter. After some time, he still hadn't returned, and a few of his friends got rather concerned. So outside they went to see what was wrong, unknowingly running into danger headlong. One by one, they went missing like Grog, there one moment, then lost to the fog. Now Scarlet, now Jacques, now Bella and Marie, gone Winston, gone Ruby, gone Ed and Susie. After a while, it came down to just three. Poor Garrett, Cornelius, and little Sparky. They regrouped inside the trusty Pine Inn, hoping they would be protected within. It's just as I feared, he would one day return. Cornelius voiced his growing concern.
Then we'll beat him again, just like before. We'll save all our friends and settle the score.
Garrett encouraged his two frightened friends, rousing their spirits to put this to an end. They made a plan to stop this festive freak. If this didn't work, then things would look bleak. Using Sparky as bait, they had set up a trap, hoping to draw out the kidnapping chap. In this unusual pile of snow, hid a secret weapon who's ready to go. It worked! The elf on the shelf had been caught, and with him the sack full of friends he had got. Inside the snowbank, all sticky and sloppy, who could it be? None other than Gloppy. Christmas was saved, and everyone was freed. The elf was defeated. Let the party proceed! All was good again after that night of thrill, when the elf broke free and ran away from the ville. But they heard him exclaim ere he went out to sight.
I'll be back once again. Goodbye, and sleep tight.